So tell me, Pierre, what can we expect from this special tonight? Kind of give us an overview about what we'll see.
Well, what we tried to do was work with our affiliate stations from around the country and for 7 days try to take a snapshot of what is being called the deadliest drug epidemic in American history. New statistics have come out, new data coming out with an estimate that in 2016 that more than 60,000 people in this country died of a drug overdose. 40,000 of those were associated with the opioid crisis, and people believe that that is what's fueling all these deaths. The fact that so many Americans are overusing prescription painkillers, hooked on heroin, and starting to use fentanyl, that is causing something that no one's ever seen before.
And you went to specific places, right? So can you tell us where you went and what places we'll see tonight?
Well, absolutely. One of the places that I spent time was in Phoenix, and we wanted to spend some time with the DEA and what turned out to be the Tempe Police Department to get a sense of how readily available the heroin is. And in that 24 hours that we were there in the Phoenix area, we saw law enforcement target a suspected drug ring. And they made arrests over the course of the hours that we were with them. And it all ended at a drug operation headquarters that was not centered in some urban location. It was a working class, middle class neighborhood where they uncovered over $1 million worth of heroin.
Wow. Also, you came to New Hampshire, correct?
I think we work with our affiliate there as well to gather material. I spent some time in your state last year, and I can recall two interviews with two young women who talked about how heroin and fentanyl had destroyed their lives. One young lady told me that heroin had taken everything from her but her life.
Let's talk about if people could take one thing away from this special tonight, what would you want them to take away about this opioid epidemic?
I think the main thing I would want them to take away is the humanity lost and to have the conversation with loved ones, family members, and associates, to warn them about the dangers of overusing painkillers, to warn them about heroin and these type of drugs, because for some people, there's no coming back.
What's one thing that surprised you, Pierre, through this research that you've done for this special? What's one thing that surprised you about this opioid epidemic? What's something you'll be taking away from this?
I think the sheer numbers. When you're talking about 60,000 people in this country dying of a drug overdose and 40,000 of those people being somehow connected to the opioid crisis, just the volume of the deaths, and also there are many more people who are overdosing and surviving, living with the struggle that they have. We spoke to one expert yesterday who said, for some of these drugs, because they change the chemical or the chemistry of the brain, it's the closest thing to losing one's free will that a person could encounter.
So I have one more question, Pierre, and I'm going to leave it up to you. Is there anything I'm missing here that you want to make sure our viewers hear from you during this interview?
Again, I would say awareness, awareness, awareness. Talk to the people in your life and let them know that this threat is out there. But it's rare when you can say something is the worst ever. And this is now the deadliest drug epidemic in the nation's history and seems to be only getting worse.
Pierre, I want to thank you for your time. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Okay.